Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel again. In our organic chemistry name reaction section, today we are going to learn about a new name reaction. So name reaction today we are going to cover is Ugi reaction. And we will learn as we are learning. First we will learn about principle, then reaction, mechanism and application, right? So let's start with the principle of Ugi reaction. So what is the principle for Ugi reaction? So the principle is very simple. It's a four component condensation reaction. See, four component condensation means what? In this reaction, you are taking four starting material, four components. That's why sometimes it is known as 4CC. 4CC reaction. What does it mean? 4 component condensation reaction. So now we will focus which component can be used for this reaction. So first component we will cover, that is carboxylic acid. Then we can also take one isocyanate compound. Then third one, amine. And fourth, carbonyl compound. See, carbonyl compound, as we already learned earlier, carbonyl may be either in form of aldehyde or maybe in form of ketone. It doesn't matter whatever you take, because we are dealing with C double bond O, carbonyl only, right? So condensation of this four component, one carboxylic acid, isocyanate compound, amine compound and carbonyl compound is resulting into the diamides. Resulting into the diamides as a product, right? So this reaction is known as Ugi condensation or Ugi reaction, right? So now let's see the reaction for this Ugi reaction. You can see one carboxylic acid is taken for identification of different R. Whatever substituent we are taking, I wrote R here. Then for amine, I wrote R1, for aldehyde, I wrote R2, for isocyanate, I wrote R3. What is the reason to write R1, R2, R3 and R to identify each of the component where it is located into the product, right? So whenever we are taking this four component and doing this Ugi reaction, we will get diamide. As you can see in the product, one amide group here, and another group here. So product is diamide compound. A compound possessing two amide is known as diamide. So as we seen in the principle, formation of diamide will be there, right? Now let's see the mechanism. It's very simple. Whenever you take the all the four components for the reaction, first definitely the amine and aldehyde will react with each other to form imine. To form imine, right? So what is imine? There is nothing but a carbon and nitrogen possessing double bond is normally known as imine. Is normally known as imine, right? So let's see how this imine is formed, right? So first, the carbonyl will always become polar in the presence of other reagents. So carbonyl electron always will be shifted towards the oxygen, always shifted towards the oxygen, right? Now, if it shifted towards the oxygen, then oxygen may have negative charge. Oxygen may have some negative charge, right? And the carbon with less positive charge due to the shifting on the electron on oxygen will get electron from the lone pair of amine. Lone pair of amine, right? So you can draw the NH2 in this way. By that, one hydrogen will donate again electron to the nitrogen, and leave its position as H+. Right? So again, nitrogen have its own lone pair because further getting from the H+. And this H plus will shifted towards the oxygen by gaining electron from the oxygen, right? So formation of OH will be there. formation of OH will be there, right? Now, this is the first intermediate for our mechanism. Now, let's see the lone pair. Lone pair present on the nitrogen will be shared to the carbon nearby, which lose its electron, donates its electron to the oxygen, and minus OH will be there. Minus OH will be there. So the positive, partial positive charge will be generated when this bond become polar, and the electron shared to this carbon will form a double bond. Form a double bond. So this is known as imine formation, right? Next step, we are taking the same imine for the next reaction with other two components, right? So one is carboxylic acid and another is isocyanate. You may think about that where the H came in the previous slide. So as carboxylic acid, gets ionized, the H will donate its own electron to the oxygen. Oxygen may have negative charge, and this H will be with the nitrogen, which will possess positive charge now. But as you know, the positive charge is unstable. So it will further try to get electron from the pi bond, double bond. So electron will be again donated to the nitrogen, right? So nitrogen may have its own lone pair again after breaking of this double bond. So see, you can see the nitrogen's lone pair is here, right? So it will get no charge, its own lone pair. But now the carbon will become positive after donating the electron of the pi bond, right? So it will get positive charge, will get electron from the isocyanate very easily. Right? So one electron with negative charge will be donated, this pair will be donated to the carbon for preparation of a covalent bond. Where is the covalent bond? So you can see this covalent bond is here, right? Now, carbon will possess neutral charge. Why? Because it donated electron here. Now, again, it will take the electron from the carboxylate ion. Electron will be donated to the carboxylate ion, right? So again, it may have negative charge, but the negative charge is not stable. So again, the electron will be donated to the nitrogen, to stabilize, right? So after getting electron, now positive charge will be removed. As you can see, the nitrogen do not have any now positive charge. Why? Because it taken electron from the pi bond. Here three bonds are there. Here you can see two bonds are there. So bonds electron is transferred towards the nitrogen. So now nitrogen may have not any charge. Right? Now this is our the next intermediate. Now if you see the electron of carbonyl, after polarization will always shifted towards the oxygen. So this may have negative charge, this may have positive charge. This positive charge will try to get the electron from the lone pair, of nitrogen, right? So formation of a new covalent bond between this carbonyl carbon and this nitrogen will have, right? So a cycle will form. How much members you can see? One here, second this oxygen, third this carbon, fourth this carbon, and fifth member is nitrogen. So now we will have a cycle, cyclic structure of five member possessing one oxygen and nitrogen, and this oxygen should possess negative charge now after get cyclized, right? So next slide we can see, the oxygen is here, this oxygen possess negative, and five member cycle is there. Rest of the things we do not touch in previous part, so they are same. Now the negative charge on the oxygen is always unstable, So it requires some positive charge to form a covalent bond between the oxygen and carbon. So now the carbon get positive charge by donating its own electron to the nitrogen, to the oxygen. This bond's electron will be shifted towards the oxygen. So this carbon may have positive charge, and this oxygen and negative. Negative and positive will form a covalent bond. This is this one. You can see, right? Now, after that, after shifting of the electron over here, this oxygen may have negative charge. This oxygen may have negative charge, but the electron of the pi bond between nitrogen and carbon will be donated to the nitrogen. Will be donated to the nitrogen. So this nitrogen will may have negative charge or lone pair, right? And this carbon may have positive charge. So the formation of covalent bond will take place. Will take place, which is here, right? And now the nitrogen will get electron and donate its own electron to the hydrogen and form a covalent bond with the hydrogen. So as you can see, after donating the electron to the hydrogen, nitrogen will have a bond with the hydrogen. And the R3 is as it is. We do not touch it, right? So if you see, this is our final compound. One amide here, another amide here. So diamide compound is formed now. So this is the mechanism for the Ugi reaction. I hope you get it very comfortably. And now we will see an application for the Ugi reaction. So you can see this compound is paramethoxy benzyl amine, right? Amine compound, right? This is parachlorobenzoic acid, acid compound, parabromobenzaldehyde, aldehyde or carbonyl compound, and the isocyanate compound we took as the isopropyl isocyanate. So if you mix all the four components, you will always get a diamide according to the Ugi reaction, and that is our product for the Ugi reaction. So this is all about the Ugi reaction. If you have any question, query, doubts, you can write in the chat box, and you can watch other name reaction in our YouTube channel in the same playlist of organic chemistry name reaction playlist, right? Thank you very much for watching. Keep share these videos to your friends in same subject. Thank you very much. Herewith we are completing this video. We will meet in the next video with another name reaction. Thank you very much.